Frequently asked questions about burns care. How is burn depth classified? Superficial or first degree burns involve only the epidermis. Like a sunburn, they are erythematous, painful, and dry. They are most often the result of severe ultraviolet exposure or minor thermal injury. First degree burns usually heal in 5 to 10 days. Superficial partial thickness or superficial second degree burns involve all of the epidermis and part of the underlying dermis. Superficial partial thickness burns damage the upper layers of the papillary dermis. They are identified by clear blisters and weeping, wet, erythematous skin, and they blanch painfully when touched. These burns heal within 2 weeks and generally do not cause scarring, however, scarring and pigment changes are possible. Deep partial thickness or deep second degree burns involve the deeper layers of the dermis or reticular dermis. They appear white and do not blanch. These burns do not heal in less than 3 weeks and often result in scarring and contractures. Third degree burns destroy all skin layers, including underlying subcutaneous fat. They are dark brown or tan and have a leathery feel with no sensitivity to touch. These wounds often require skin grafts, and can result in contractures. How is burn size classified? Burn size is determined by estimating the percentage of the patient's body surface area that is covered by partial thickness and full thickness burns. First degree burns are not incorporated into formal estimations of burn size. The Lund-Browder classification can be used for initial assessment of burn size in adults or children. The Rule of Nines diagram is helpful for rapid assessment of burn size, but this method is less accurate than the Lund-Browder classification, especially in children. What is the initial evaluation of burns? The initial evaluation should include a primary survey, ensuring that body surface areas are covered after inspection because damage to the epidermis can result in temperature regulation problems. Because of the risk of airway edema and possible inhalation injury, burns to the face or neck should always prompt evaluation of the patient's airway, regardless of the burn size. The secondary survey should include a careful evaluation of the burned area and consideration of abuse. The size, depth, and circumference of the burn should be evaluated. A tetanus shot should be given to all patients with more than a first degree burn. What is the initial treatment of superficial burns? Immediate treatment of minor thermal burns with cool running water is controversial but often recommended. Although cool water is an acceptable home treatment for minor burns, ice water immersion is not because it can lead to further injury and hypothermia. Any materials that could cause further injury should be removed. How should pain control be applied? Immediate attention should be given to pain control. Because burns can take weeks to heal, judicious use of narcotic analgesics is recommended. Adequate analgesia should be obtained before cleaning the wound or applying dressings. How should the wound be cleaned? Scrubbing the wound with povidone iodine solution, chlorhexidine, or other cleaning agents is not recommended. Cleaning the wound with sterile water is generally adequate to remove debris. What is the management for blisters? Small blisters less than 6 mm should be left intact. Large blisters with thin walls should be debrided. They will likely rupture on their own, and it is beneficial from a pressure and infection standpoint to apply dressings directly to the wound bed. Blisters that prevent proper movement of a joint or that are likely to rupture should be debrided. What is the role of topical agents? Burn wounds heal best in moist, not wet, environments that promote re-epithelialization and prevent cellular dehydration. This environment is best created by applying a topical agent or occlusive dressing to reduce fluid loss. Topical agents provide pain control, promote healing, and prevent wound infection and desiccation. Which topical agents are suitable? Superficial burns can be treated successfully with topical application of lotion, honey, aloe vera, or antibiotic ointment. The lipid component of these treatments accelerates the repair of damaged skin and reduces drying. Partial thickness burns should be treated with a topical antimicrobial agent or an absorptive occlusive dressing to reduce pain, promote healing, and prevent wound desiccation. Topical silver sulfadiazine is the standard antimicrobial treatment for partial thickness burns. However, it is relatively contraindicated in patients with sulfur allergy, pregnant and lactating women, and newborns. Is there a role for topical corticosteroids? Topical corticosteroids have not been shown to reduce the inflammatory reaction, therefore, they should not be used to treat superficial thermal burns or sunburns. Is there a role for prophylactic systemic antibiotics? A systematic review showed that prophylactic systemic antibiotics administered in the hospital setting did not improve mortality. Therefore, they generally are not recommended for burns. What are the possible complications of burns? Pruritus and neuropathic pain are common post-burn complications. Histamine H1 receptor antagonists such as cetirizine are the safest pharmacologic treatment for post-burn pruritus. Although cellulitis is not common in burns, it can cause the skin to become severely erythematous, exudative, painful, and swollen. Infections can progress rapidly. Some of the most common pathogens found in burn wounds include Staphylococcus aureus, Streptococcus pyogenes, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and Acinetobacter and Klebsiella species. Antibiotic treatment depends on local drug resistance and should be tailored toward broad coverage of gram-negative and gram-positive bacteria. What is criteria for referral to a burn center for treatment? Any patient with burns and concomitant trauma in whom the burn injury poses the greatest risk of morbidity or death. Burns in children at hospitals without qualified personnel or equipment for the care of children. Burns in patients who will require special social, emotional, or rehabilitative intervention. Burns in patients with pre-existing medical disorders that could complicate management, prolong recovery, or affect mortality. Burns that involve the face, hands, feet, genitalia, perineum, or major joints. Chemical burns. Electrical burns, including lightning injury. Inhalation injury. Partial thickness burns on more than 10% of the total body surface area. Third degree burns in any age group.
Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.